The following program is paid for by friends and partners of Apostle Guillermo Maldonado and King Jesus International Ministry.
On today's episode of The Supernatural Now.
What God brought you here today to tell you, I want my will to be done, so you need to pray every day, Father, let your will be done in my life, let your will be done in my family, let your will be done in my business, let your will be done in my job, let your will be done. God said, if my will comes, provision, joy, peace is coming.
Jesus came to earth to teach and to demonstrate the supernatural with miracles, signs, and wonders. God doesn't change. God is supernatural. Apostle Guillermo Maldonado is called to bring God's supernatural power to this generation. For over 25 years, he has been teaching and activating believers from around the world to do the same. Get ready to receive your miracle today and allow God to use you to demonstrate His power here and now. This is a reality you can experience in your life today. Join us as we see more of the supernatural now.
Blessing, I'm Apostle Guillermo Maldonado. I welcome you to the Supernatural Now. I want you to be ready to understand and to get a revelation about the Abba Father prayer. You know, when Jesus came, Jesus taught prayer, not only taught, but also He was the model. And then He said, I'm gonna show you the pattern and the principle on the Abba Father prayer. Many of you are desiring, you have the desire to pray effectively. And sometimes as Christian, we get confused. And sometimes as Christian, we don't have results. We pray and we don't see any results. We get frustrated. We stop praying because we think that it doesn't work. It's not that it doesn't work. It's a matter of knowing the revelation behind what Jesus said, Abba Father that is in heaven. What does that mean? What does that mean when He said, let your kingdom come, let your will be done on earth? How can we apply it daily? How can we take the prayer and follow that guide? I call it the pattern that Jesus established that you can follow through and you can have powerful, effective prayer life. It's not just a repetition. It's not just another prayer that you can follow the steps, step one, step two. It's not about that. It's full of revelation in that Abba Father prayer. So I want you to go now and listen and see this powerful revelation in the Abba Father prayer, and your prayer life will go to another dimension. Let's watch.
I want to welcome all the people that are watching by the internet and by television, the Supernatural Now. Put your hand together, give them a big praise. Hey, Jesus. How to know the will of God in your life. Number one, and I want you to write it down, please. Let your will be done on earth as it is in. Okay, now, this is my first bullet point. My first bullet point is this. The will of God is a mystery. The will of God is a mystery. What is the will of God? It's a mystery. Why? Because not everything is known. That is the reason is the mystery is not known. Pastor, I don't know if I open this business. I don't know if I study this career. I don't know. So that means you don't know. It's a mystery. That's why, can I hear an amen? So that's the reason the will of God is a mystery. But what is the will of God? If you want to write it down in very simple terms, the will of God in the Abba Father prayer, which we need to pray every day. That's what the Abba Father prayer is, to pray every day. I pray for the will of God every day in my life to be done. So the will of God is the mind of God make known to men in the now. Is the mind of God make known to men in the now? In other words, is God revealing what He thinks now about you? That's what the will of God is how do you access to His mind? Because this year we need to know, what's the will of God for me? What do you want me to do, Jesus? Can I hear an amen? So is God's will make known to me and to you, to men? in the now. So we need to have access into his mind. So when we pray, we must pray according to his will, meaning something that is already known. There's two, if we can see the expression of the will of God in two areas. Number one, in his word. The word of God is the will of God. It is his will is written here. Number two is also expressed in the Rhema word, which is something that is not here yet. When you need to ask him questions and said, I need to make this trip, but I don't know it's the will of God for me to do this. And then it's not in the word. So that's why you need to get the Rhema word for the now, to know that God speaks to you in the situation that you need now. So all prayer, say it with me, all prayer are based on the will of God. Say it again. All prayer. Okay, in other words, you make sure when we pray is according to the will of God. Why? Because if I pray according to his will, I know I will have provision. I know I will have joy. I know I will have healing. I know I will have peace. I know because it's according to the will of God. So number two, the flow of the supernatural is based on the will of God. It's not based on the will of men. It's the will of God. What does it mean then to be the will of God to be done? Let's go to the scriptures again. See what the Bible says. He says, you will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Lift your hands and say it with me. Come on, everybody. 1, 2, 3, go. Say it louder. Earth will be done on earth as it is in? As it is in? I want you to see present tense in what you're reading. As it is now. So remember what I said about the Abba Father prayer? It's bringing heaven on earth in a visible way. It's a demonstration of God's, that's the Abba Father prayer. That's the purpose of the Abba Father prayer. It's a pattern for you to pray, but also it's bringing heaven on earth in a visible dimension. So he said, let's the will of God be done on earth as it is in heaven. Say it again. Heaven. For the will of God to be done, and then he said, for the will of God to be done, it has to be known. You don't do the will of God if you don't know what it is. You only do it when you know it. Can I hear an amen, guys? So for the will of God to be known, it has to be known. Where the will of God is known will be done. So you can have the best intentions, but if you don't know the will of God for your family, the will of God for what you're going to study, the will of God for your spouse, your wife, or the person you're going to get married with, or you're going to move from another country, from another city. If you don't know the will of God, how are you going to do it? But today, because we pressure God, we're not willing to wait for him to reveal his will. I can't break into his mind and say, open your mind and tell me. We can, because God's thoughts are conceived. And not break in. In other words, you can go and get in God's mind and say, you show me your will. If you don't, I'm going to get into your mind. He can't. He has to be conceived. In other words, his thoughts come to you when you are one in your mind with him. Yeah. You need to be willing to wait for him to reveal what's God's will for your life. Number two. So Romans chapter 12, verse 2, you will see something powerful. And do not conform to this world. Every time you see the word conform, shout and say, conform. Conform. Lift your hands and say it. Conform. Everyone, you see the word conform, that word is always, always related to the kingdom of darkness. Always. When you see that person is conformed to his sickness, meaning he's conformed to the kingdom of darkness. He's stagnated. He's not moving. He's not progressing. Any conformed person is a conformism. It's a person that is conformed. So anything that has to do with conformism has to do with the kingdom of darkness. That's what happened to Adam when he fell. So in Adam was conform. Adam was conform. Jesus was restoration. Jesus was not conform. Jesus was transform. So if you conform, listen, if you conform, you're not growing. If you conform, you're not changing. If you conform, you're not moving. If you conform, your reality is natural. If you conform, you're not prospering. If you conform, you're not progressing. If you conform, you're not doing anything. You're not going forward. You're going backward. Why? You conform because you not only conform. When you conform, you're going backwards. You go into the old habits. You go into the old ways. You go into the old way thinking. So you must, if you conform, you conform to the other kingdom. If you transform, you're progressing. If you conform, you're changing. If you conform, you're doing something different. If you transform, you're being changed from glory to glory. If you try, so we must be transformed. Where are we being be transformed? With the word, with the presence, with the power. We're being changed. We're being transformed. If you conform, you're religious. If you transform, you're supernatural.
What is the will of God? Will of God is the mind of God revealing the now. And then he said, that you may be proved, maybe you experience. Make people can tell you, oh, I know what it feels, the presence of God. When the presence of God comes upon you, and I know what it feels. You say, well, but I need to feel it myself. Meaning, I want to experience it firsthand. And but you can't know his will until you change your cabeza. Touch your neighbor and tell her, cabeza. Your head needs to be changed, your mind. You can be, it's like, Jesus, I want to have my own business. Yeah, but I don't have money. Change your cabeza. Change your mind. You need to see yourself healthy. I'm going to release a bomb here, okay? It's part of my book on deliverance. You know what fear is? Just let me detour for a moment, then I come back. I'm a good teacher, so I don't want to go back into what I'm doing. Okay. Fear is the perversion of the mind of God. So he said, do not conform to this world, but be transformed. Lift your hands and say, be transformed. The word transformed by the renewal. Let's tell you how. They tell you how, by the renewing of the mind. How do you renew the mind? Put the word into it. Hear the word into it all the time. Put more word. Read the Bible. Go. Read books on transformation. Apostle Maldonado got a one. For Jesus' sake, get the book. Get transformed. Not get religious. You need to move. You need to be changing. You need to progressing. You need to be changing. The one that I saw last year cannot be the same of this year because there's transformation. Turn to your neighbor and tell them, transformation. So he said, be transformed by the renewing of the mind. Get the word. Put it in your mind. Get it. Be where you be transformed. You transform in the presence of God. And then he said, by the renewing of your mind, and they tell you the reason. That you may prove. How do you prove the will of God? You will have peace. How do you prove the will of God? You will have joy. How do you prove the will of God? You will have provision. How do you prove the will of God? You will have protection. How do you prove the will of God? But listen, prove means experience at first hand. You cannot prove the will of God. If the will of God is for you to be a millionaire, you cannot experience how it feels to be a millionaire until you renew your mind. Three progressive steps of the will of God. I want you to look at me. God is not schizophrenic. Oh, I am not in the perfect will of God, but in his permissive will. You religious, repent. Because God doesn't have permissive will. He's not schizophrenic. He only has one will. What is his will? For you to be healed.
for you to be prosper, for you to be transformed, for you to be healthy, for you to be strong, full of joy, for you to have peace, for you to have joy. That is the will of God. Touch your neighbor, tell them, that's the will of God for my life. So what God brought you here today to tell you, I want my will to be done. So you need to pray every day, Father, let your will be done in my life. Let your will be done in my family. Let your will be done in my business. Let your will be done in my job. Let your will be done. God said, if my will comes, provision, joy, peace is coming. Somebody have to lift your hands. Somebody have to say amen. Somebody have to say, I bring the will. I bring the will into earth. Are you prepared for this year? Are you prepared for the will of God? So you need to change the way you think. Don't change like a poor man. Don't change like a sick person. Don't change like the old one that I can't do anything. All things I can do through Jesus Christ to strengthen you. Just start changing the way you think. Don't think like poor me, poor me, poor me. Shake it up, poor you, poor the devil. No, 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 no. No self-esteem, self-pity. Get out of self-pity. You don't want self-pity in your life. You want Jesus. You want the will of God. Man, I want to start running in the aisles. I want to start running. Is God's will to be promoted in your job? Is God's will to be promoted? Is God's will to give you a promotion? Is God's will to give you an increase? Is God's will? Is God's will? Is God's will? Is God's will? Somebody have to say, it's God's will. It's God's will. It's God's will. Pour me, pour me, pour me. Self-pity is a spirit. Self-pity is a spirit. You don't want God to say, poor guy, poor guy. No, you say, God, I will attract your will. I will bring your will. Your will shall be done in my life. Pray that every day. Lift your hands and say, I will pray every day. I will pray every day. God's will to be done. And I want you to shout, let your will be on earth.
Stay tuned for Supernatural Testimonies.
How long have you been suffering with arthritis?
About 2 years.
2 years. The Lord said to me, there's a person with arthritis, and the reason is because unforgiveness. Some people hurt you and cause you a lot of pain. And this is what you hold it in your heart, son. The reason you hold it, you know why? Because it was unfair. And they hurt you. I want you to lift your hands. Let's enforce the will. In heaven, there's no unforgiveness. You know how many blessings have been held in heaven because of that. Say with me, Father, I forgive all those that hurt me. Forgive me. I forgive them all. And right now, in the name of Jesus, I receive your forgiveness. I am healed in my body. Arthritis. Go! Jesus. Tell me what happened.
Dr. William, 2 years from his waist down with arthritis, pain in his knees, pain in his sides. But the power of God, he forgave the people who have been hurting him, and now he is completely healed and set free.
What did you feel, son? What did you feel?
All the pain is gone, and I'm free.
Pastor, for 14 years she's been suffering with cysts, discomfort every month, but her cycle comes. But she felt, when you released the word, she felt the presence of God began to shake, and God healed her.
I'm 28 years old, and since I was 14, they told me I had cysts. Last year I was in the hospital and they found 3 cysts on my right ovary, 1 on my left. It caused me to have a miscarriage, and I started praying to God to heal me whenever my cycle came along. It's really bad. My husband can testify to it. Sometimes my pressure drops. I faint because the pains are so strong. Sometimes I'm screaming on the floor, and I was right now in the front and I just felt the presence, and I started shaking, and I felt some warmth, and I wanted to laugh and I wanted to cry at the same time.
Come on!
All I felt was happiness. I felt peace. I felt like the Holy Spirit was working on me. And while you were speaking, I was like, God, just forgive any of my sins. Forgive any of the things that I've done wrong. But just heal me, because I know it's your will for me to be healed.
Wow, you got the message, sister. Thank you. Put your hands together, guys. Come on.
Apostle Thank Jackie, you, for 8 years, she had cysts in her ovaries. Because of that, she said that her whole right side would hurt. The pain, she's had it for 8 years. You spoke the word, the power of God came upon her. She said she couldn't even bend down. She's completely healed now.
Come on in, Jesus. Daughter, what are you crying?
I had pain for 8 years. 8 years I take medication every day of my life. This leg here gives so much problem, but I felt the anointing. And now I can bend my leg and I don't feel no pain now.
Come on in, Jesus. Say, let your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Thank you, Jesus.
To share your supernatural testimony, please write to us at 14100 Southwest 144th Avenue, Miami, Florida 33186, or email us at testimonies@kingjesusministry.org.
My friend, if you've been watching this show and you never received Jesus as your personal Savior, you know you can start this relationship with God. God is your Father, you are His Son, His daughter. And can you allow me to do this prayer? If you never received Jesus as your personal Savior in your life, repeat this prayer out loud. Wherever you're at now, say with me, Father God, I recognize that I am a sinner. I repent of all my sins. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is my Lord and my Savior. Thank you, Lord. Amen and amen. If you did this prayer, thank you for doing this. And I know if you're watching, if you're sick in your body, if you're going through crisis, and right now you're saying, yes, I need healing, I need deliverance, I need provision, can you stretch your hands and let me pray for you? Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I rebuke every spirit of sickness in the body of the people right now. Be healed. Those that are oppressed, afflicted in your mind, you're struggling with fighting with bad thoughts and fear in your mind, I command in the name of Jesus, I set you free. I deliver you now, and I release freedom in your mind, freedom in your emotions. Right now, Lord, bring provision into your people and those that need creative miracles. If you need to create a miracle in your body, there's an organ missing in your body, I declare creative miracles now in Jesus' mighty name. Receive it now. Receive it. Thank you, Lord. I give you praise and I give you honor. Amen and amen. God bless you.
Enseñan a escribir, a leer a la palabra de Dios, que voy a la iglesia a aprender.
Me gusta pintar y a leer y a escribir y aprender.
Aquí me quieren, me aman y me cuidan y no van a dejar que nadie me toque.
In these homes, we not only supply their needs, we give them love and security, and form them academically and spiritually, focusing at all times on their relationship with God. This is just a small part of King Jesus Ministries' contribution to missions. Please partner with us today to support sharing the supernatural love of God around the world.
Are you looking for the truth? What is the truth? Many of us seek something real for our lives. We wonder if it is possible to have peace, purpose, and empowerment in a world that seems to be falling apart with each passing day. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Yet who is this Jesus? And if he truly was the Savior, in what way does that reality affect us today? And why should we believe in him? In this book, you will find the meaning behind the life and teachings of Jesus Christ and learn how his existence connects with your purpose.
I bless you. I'm Apostle Guillermo Maldonado, and why believe in Jesus? We're going to send you this book. This is a very powerful book. And if you partner today, we're going to send you this book for free. But at the same time, if you said, yeah, I want to sign now, I want to register as a partner and be part of this supernatural movement around the world, we're going to send you a pin right now. Can you give us a call? And you can get now this pin into your hands and also this book. You will be blessed. And let me tell you, there's so many truths that I share in this book, and it will change your life. God bless you.
At King Jesus International Ministry, we are committed to sharing the supernatural power of God around the globe. Today, we would like to invite you to become a partner with us and leave a lasting impact for the kingdom of God. Your prayers and monthly gifts will help fund orphanages, medical support, inner city outreach, prison ministry, feeding the hungry, and bring transformation with the power of salvation through Jesus Christ. You can call now and become a partner with Apostle Guillermo Maldonado. Commit today to bring the supernatural power of God to this generation.
Get ready to experience God's supernatural power in 2015, June 19th through the 20th, Deborah's Women Conference, June 24th through the 27th, Supernatural Fivefold Ministry School, July 31st through August 1st, Chosen Generation Youth Conference, October 8th through the 10th, Apostolic and Prophetic Conference, November 14th through the 23rd, Journey Through Israel. For more information, visit kingjesusministry.org/events.
Thank you for watching today's program. If you want to learn more on how to accelerate and enable you to experience the supernatural in your life, contact us today. Join us next time as we see more of the supernatural now.
The previous program was paid for by the friends and partners of Apostle Guillermo Maldonado and King Jesus International Ministry.